Awesome. What's going on, everybody?
Skinny penis.
See, I knew that was going to happen. Son. I knew every time, man. Every
God
time.
God dang it, dude.
Fucking A, man.
Welcome back to the Havoc Podcast.
Today, we're playing what? Fishing Simulator? Is that what you said? All right, dude. I love that game. I love that game, dude. It's like, you know how it, like, I don't know if you guys have, like, those chain pizza restaurants that have, like, the arcades in them. There's one near me called CeCe's. It's pretty lit.
CeCe's Pizza? CeCe's Pizza.
Dude.
They have, like, an arcade in the back. They had this one called, like, Bass Fishing.
Pac-Man?
Bass Fishing. Pac-Man. It's pretty close, dude. Yeah.
Yeah, you got close, Uber. By the way, special guest Catjoy Miel. That's pretty cool. We haven't started officially yet, but I'm just throwing it out there.
Officially.
10 out of 10.
And fun fact, Kat is special in two different ways, mentally, and she's here, which she's usually not.
I guess we can do the... Should we do the intro now? Just get the intro out here?
What intro, dude?
No one's actually in here yet, so I don't know if we should start. But, I mean, we still can.
What do you mean?
Yeah.
The only person who typed in chat was Uber, and he did not say... Like, you know, the most.
Oh, I said a naughty word.
Oh my god.
That's the only.
Remove it.
You know, usually you click the button to say remove, but you know, whatever.
I removed it. It's all good. Fellar. You know, Fellar is spelled with an E, right?
Yeah, two E's. No A's.
It annoys
people. Or if you really want to, you can spell it Fellar with a U. Fellar.
Or you can spell it like this. Like
no, he's literally just gonna spell pussy. I know he.
Oh, no, man. I'm gonna spell like
I thought he was just gonna type in pussy. That's how FaZe told you to type.
By the way, is the game good quality? Like, cause
oh,
I can't.
Oh yeah,
really...
it's lit. It looks
it's
nice.
Lit.
Oh,
that's sick, dude.
Yeah. It's at least like, it's at least 40p, right now.
Yeah, solid 180p.
That's sick.
So how's everybody doing?
Pretty good.
I don't know, dude. I'm hyped. So you're playing Skyrim, right? The new one.
Oh, I forgot.
The new one.
We have a special guest today.
No. Oh my god. Oh my god.
We didn't forget to mention
we didn't.
That at all.
We didn't forget. You forgot.
In like one tiny.
You guys
bit.
Forgot.
Hey, Pixel Gamer. Pixel Gamer is here, by
dude,
the way.
Speaking of which, we were gonna talk today about the future of Havoc, and With Uber leading Havoc, this is the future that we have. literally just him repeating the same thing over and over again.
Hey, you guys want to play Havoc?
This is the sad future that we have. Oh, frick.
Oh my God.
We should actually probably start the podcast now. Instead of
no, but in all seriousness, yeah, I think we should just jump into it, talk about some goals, dude.
Alright, so we're gonna. I'll do. No, we gotta do the intro. Like we always
do. No, we don't. The introduction. All right, welcome.
So, yo, guys, what's up? We're from the stream, and right now we're doing a Havoc podcast, and we're playing Skyrim. This is the remastered, aka.
We're all playing
edition.
It together. It's now a
no,
multiplayer.
Just the one
game,
person did.
Yeah, just it is, but. The IP of the server is empty to
it's gonna be this. Oh my god.
Use code Adaraxian for free server.
True.
Now we can actually
try to use that one day.
Give me time. By the way, people typed in chat too much, and now I can't see the topics, so I'm relying on you guys to know the topics.
I got you. First thing we're talking about is the goals for YouTube for this year, not for next
spell
year.
Spell the remainder
year.
Wrong.
What do you want to get done? No, you didn't. What do you want to get done for like 2016? What do you want to get
not
done?
Not upload any more videos.
I upload at least one video.
Dude, can you turn your gain down or move away from your microphone, please?
Me?
You sound like a snowman.
I know you're doing it on purpose, but I'm begging you.
Do you wanna be a snowman?
See, if I'm this close and then I go here, it like loses.
No, we should make a book series. Moving back in time, future for Havoc, we should make a book series. We should do like the side
books. Hell yeah, we should do
that. Havoc dot books.
How to draw, penis. How to draw like penises, I'll be the quickest kid book. How to draw different flavors ice creams, that's pretty good.
Oh my god, okay, what's the first topic? Oh yeah, we already did it.
Topic. What the
I think my goal for YouTube is to actually start uploading again.
Oh, true.
It's probably
Evil, when's the last time you uploaded?
About a month ago.
Dude.
That's more an active than Uber.
I think I want to make it by the end of this year. I want to make it to like 1500 subscribers. That's the goal. Or that, or like 40,000 views. Because right now I'm hovering at 30,000.
These kids are saying we're freaking. I mean, our viewers said we freaking ruined kids' books.
Great job, you ruined kid books. So true. We ruin everything. Just get used to it, to be honest. But yeah, what about you, Jake? What do you feel?
For you? Wait, by the end of 2016?
By the end of 2016.
Yeah. Oh, frick,
January,
dude.
What do you want to get done?
I don't know. I mean, I want to get back on the schedule and begin uploading. Because I haven't, as of right now, I haven't uploaded in like 2 days, I think. Oh, freaking.
Yeah, no, I feel that. I'm kind of struggling right now. Like, this is the only thing that I've done in like 2.5 days now, I think. And the last thing that I did was a stream, not a video. So I'm kind of struggling when it comes down to it, like to get stuff out consistently. But my next video is actually going to be pretty lit. I'm doing a setup tour because I finally got my new case. It's gorgeous, dude. It's gorgeous. I got the Deep Cool Tesseract White Edition. I didn't end up going for the side window, but I got a bunch of blue LEDs on it, and it's looking lit.
AF.
true.
All right. Cat.
What about, Cat, what are you feeling? You're about to hit 1K, right? You're almost at 800, and then after that, you're trying to hit that 1K mark, right?
Yeah, 1K by Christmas. That's what I want.
Oh my gosh, that would be a great Christmas present. I'll be honest with you, Kat. I'm gonna let you know right now, it really doesn't feel that different. Once you hit 1K, like after that, you literally are just, you're the same person doing the same thing. It's like your 18th birthday, you know what I mean? You think you're gonna, like, it's gonna be great. You're gonna be like, oh yeah, I turned 18, but like, it just happens, and the next day you're like, I feel exactly the same. But it's awesome. Like, I love everybody that thought that it would be cool to take time out of their day to press a little red button, but I mean, it doesn't change you that much.
All right,
I didn't forget where I came from, bro. You gotta remember your roots.
Yeah, dude, Access SMP, the biggest root of them all.
Oh my god, let's not talk about it.
Let's not. Okay.
Heck no.
All right. I guess I'll talk about mine. Well, because alright, so this is for 2017, because I think the rest of the year I'm not really going to do too much, just because of Havoc.host. I've been working on that.
Sound that? That's good.
Yeah, well, no, I'm trying to lower it. I'll go a little in depth. I want to try to stick away from Havoc.host for the most part, but yeah, that's one of the reasons I can't really stream and upload. I want to do like almost daily streams. I was doing a good little bit for like 2 days. I did that twice, and I was like, damn, I'm feeling good. And then some stuff came up with Havoc.host. Currently, just for like the multi-craft panel, we're paying like $100 a month. It's pretty ridiculous.
Yeah, that is pretty mad.
Yeah.
I think it's actually great that you're focusing on that. Like, even if Havoc.host as a business doesn't work out, which, I mean, I think it's going to. I think, like, because honestly, if you just get like, what is it? Like, the cheapest plan is like, what, $4?
$1. Come on, Seth.
Seriously? Wow. Yeah. Maybe
this shit by heart, dude.
I don't. I haven't purchased a server from you. I'm sorry, man.
You better fucking look at the website.
I do want to cancel because I'm currently paying for a server with somebody else. So I want to kind of cancel that and then get a server with you instead.
Havoc.host.
I've been lazy. I'll probably do that before they take my money for this next month.
All right, but try to stay on top of here. My bad. I didn't want to go.
No, it's all good.
But yeah, next year I definitely do plan to try to upload at least once a month. That'll be pretty good, I think.
Honestly, no matter what, you should always try to go for like kind of a consistent schedule. So make it like something that's like realistic for you. Like if it's every other day, then just try to do every other day. Don't like overreach and try to go for every day if you can't get out like quality videos every day.
The problem with me and uploading, I get distracted really easily. So 1 minute I'm like, yeah, I want to go record, and then like the next 2 hours I'm like freaking jerking the tune or something.
Yeah, that's that's never actually been a problem for me, to be completely honest with you.
Well, I always get distracted. I'm like, I'm pretty busy, but yeah.
Die, man. I see your health going down.
Yeah, no, I don't. No, I'm good. I just turned into a vampire. I don't even know what that means, so I'm kind of scared. But
oh, dude, I've played as a vampire. I'm not gonna tell you what happens. But moving on, actually, I wanted to talk, like, we've got Kat here today, and this is kind of a thing that I really wanted to talk to her about. I think this is important, because Kat is PG every day of the week, but on the weekends...
Yeah.
Hey, listen, I'm not... I wasn't done, girl. But on the weekends, you sit there and you do your non-PG streams, and I think they're great. Personally, like, when you do non-PG Overwatch streams, That's the content of viewers that I actually really like.
Called out.
It's what I love.
No, I'm not trying to be mean. I wouldn't watch my content if I were like myself. Like, I mean, well, I would because I'm awesome. But I mean, I feel like the PG content is obviously geared toward younger kids, and it means that, like, if their parents walk in and see them like watching somebody on YouTube, they're not gonna get in trouble for like a bunch of, you know, F-bombs being dropped around. You know what I mean? So that's like a good thing for that. But then also, like, non-PG streams are, in my opinion, way funnier, or non-PG content in general. Yeah, also, yeah. That's true.
Like, I think, personally, that's one of the problems why I don't PG stream. Well, aka, I suck at, like, not swearing. I swear a lot. Even at school, I do it. So I just drop a random F-bomb in class, but yeah. I try not to swear. Like, I was trying to do it for one stream, I think, and I sort of sucked at that. So, I don't know, I probably will never be PG just because, fuck it, I think being PG is being a pussy, and PG, you should go kill yourself.
There. Oh my god.
Poor cat. I don't know, like, I'm trying to walk the line, like, I curse, obviously, like, in my normal life, and I'm, like, trying to, I don't want to, like, you know, remove every time that I curse from my videos. So I've been like trying to like bleep it out, because I feel like that doesn't take away from the humor and it doesn't take away from the realness of the content, but it does, like, obviously it keeps the word. Like, if you watch something on TV and somebody says fuck, you know, they bleep it out, like, you still know what's happening, but it's just like a courtesy. You know what I mean?
Personally,
with my content itself, like, I obviously can't do that for streams though, which is a struggle for me.
Well, personally, that's why I don't really watch Beijing Canadian anymore, because I really don't. As a kid, I liked this content, sure, but I do like mature content. I don't want to hear a freaking beep. If I did beeps every 5 seconds, there'd be a fucking beep, right? So, you know, I don't really like the beeping thing, to be honest. I think I'd rather just hear.
I think it adds comedy, like a comedic, like, factor to it.
Yeah, definitely,
like,
does.
Like, I'm gonna link you guys to one of my videos, you know, shameless advertising. There's a particular video, in fact, there's a few of them that have been, like, specifically for humorous, like, effect. Like, there's one that I just uploaded that was literally just titled, Oh My God. And it's a 46-second video that literally, like, it kills me every time I watch it. And this is the kind of content that I really want to produce, but it's not, like, the kind of content. I'm going to go ahead and put it in stream chat just in case anybody that's watching wants to go ahead and watch it. But, yeah, like, that's the kind of stuff that I want to produce, but I feel like it's not the kind of stuff that actually does well on my channel. Like, this particular video actually has 79 views, but obviously as just a 45-second video, there's no way I'll ever get ad revenue from this video, which sounds like totally like like selloutish, but it's just not, like, I don't know. When I do this sort of thing on longer videos, people don't really like it that much. Like, they're like over edited, whatever. Like, if you see on my channel as well, I've done like a bunch of uncut Skywars. Those do way better than the regular Skywars videos that I was doing, because the Skywars videos that I did do were like, you know, it was like really cut up and like a cut commentary kind of thing that was focused less on the gameplay and more on kind of like talking to my audience. But yeah. I don't know what I should do, and I don't know how I'm gonna do it, and that's pretty much it. I think that's a good thing.
You
I'm just on. Lost when it comes to YouTube. I'm still trying to find my niche, and I'm struggling with it. Like, obviously, in terms of content, Skywars.
But you do know that your mother's calling you, right, Uber?
What's up?
You do know that your mom's calling you, right?
Mom!
Oh my god, wrecked.
I'm just, right. You can just hear her screaming in the background. I didn't want it.
I didn't hear
her. Mom, okay. I'm busy.
Oh my god. Minecraft. Alright, but yeah, so actually that's brought up something really good. I forgot who was watching Edirax, but
yeah.
Someone did bring something up that... So your Skywars videos, the unedited ones, you have to agree those definitely take a lot less work. But
way less work. I'm very open about the fact that, like, the first one that I did, I literally told everybody the reason that I'm doing this is because I don't feel like editing right now, and I wanted to try it. I saw somebody, I think it was Aaron, he literally uploaded one a while ago. He does it as a series now, I think, but it's stuff like that. Like, was it yours?
Yeah.
Well, lit. Thanks, man. But like, what was it? Uncut Skywars. Yeah, on October 17th, Uncut Skywars in quotation marks, aka an excuse to release fully unedited footage because I'm lazy. It was like, I don't know.
Cool. Yeah, so I was gonna bring this up because I wasn't gonna bash on you, but for not editing. But yeah, I know what you're saying. But pretty much like with YouTube nowadays, it's pretty complicated because you get like people that some of these bigger YouTubers that like, to be honest, they put shit effort into their videos, but they grow at like tremendous rates.
I know exactly what you mean.
Let's go. I'm not trying to bash on people who do reaction videos for all their videos. But to be honest, like those take no effort. I'm just throwing it out there. Like legit, all they do is just sit in front of a webcam and like, there's really no editing. You don't even need to edit if you really don't want to use it.
But the thing is, those particular videos do really well. Like, you know, David in Blackshirt, David Games YT, his biggest video is a reaction video to a trailer.
Yeah, it's crazy.
It's so awful. Like, I mean, that's the kind of content that people want, which is, I mean, it's annoying, but
it's annoying. I think too, like when you put a bunch of editing into a video and you're so psyched for it, and then all of a sudden it's like the video does shit, you're like, well, yes, why am I even bothering?
I hate it. My life.
Yeah, and then you're like,
then the video.
Like, that's how I feel about all those like amazing cut commentaries that I work on. Like when I put out Bad Lion videos, I put a lot of effort into those. Like I make them kind of humorous. I try to make it so that the commentary flows well. Do a little bit of editing. And obviously, Bad Lion is way harder to me than Skywars because I'm not actually good at PvP. I'm just, you know, good at throwing people off the edge of islands. But Bad Lion videos, I put a lot of effort into, and like, at most, those get like 60 views. And then my Hypixel Skywars videos, like, I've got, you know, streams where 20 people have joined my party. And they're all like, oh my gosh, can we be friends? Like, I love your videos and stuff like that. And it gets like this amazing response. And I'm just sitting here like, why? I'm putting so much less effort into this than I would like this other video. And I'm getting a much better response, which is like, I mean, it's cool, but I feel like it's just unfair to me and to them even. Like, I don't know.
Yeah, some of my most viewed videos are like, I didn't put a lot of effort into them. And like some of my, like I put a lot of effort into some of my videos, and like my montages, for example, because those take a lot of while to edit, and those don't get as much views. So I don't really like, it's hard to tell, but you always want your content to be the best for like the viewers. You always want to edit it really well, so it really looks like professional and like looks from different. Like with people uploading, I'm not trying to bash anyone that does, but because I do it myself sometimes, but just like uncut videos where they just upload like a whole entire hour's worth of gameplay, for example. Sometimes those actually do really good. Like on my channel, those used to get really good views when I used to upload compared to my editing videos. So I don't really know. It's really hard to like to know like what your viewers want. And
the thing is that video length actually has a lot to do, and I think Cap might have been about to say this, maybe it's something totally different, but video length has a lot to do with how the YouTube algorithm actually decides how many views something has. So for like an hour-long video, somebody might only watch like the first 5 minutes of that, but since they watched 5 minutes of a video, like it's more than if somebody watched the entirety of my 46-second video. You know what I mean?
Yeah, like, that's why YouTubers like Leafy and stuff like that, they upload, like they make it really long. Because the 10-minute mark, it makes more money, and it does, like, yeah, what you were saying, exactly.
Mm-hmm. It's quite annoying. Oh, go ahead, Kat. Sorry, I've talked too much.
I was gonna say, I think it's more important to do, like, if you want to put editing into the video, do it. Like, do what you want to do. And
yeah, no, I 100% agree. The thing, it's just disappointing to have content that you're really, really proud of go up on your channel where you're still, like, your channel's doing well. My channel is doing well right now. But, like, I put up, you know, content that I'm super proud of, and I watch it get a terrible response compared to this video that I spent like, you know, 15 minutes on, literally like all the time that I recorded it, and then I put music behind it, and then I uploaded it. That was it. Like, there was no effort. I didn't cut anything. I didn't change anything. I mean, I put the effort into playing the game and commentating and trying not to look like a sweat on my camera, but you know, like that's it. Like, speaking of which, total aside, I literally don't know how to not look like I'm sweating in video games in my face cam. It's such a problem for me right now.
It's hilarious. That's hilarious.
Like, I keep watching videos back,
gotta,
and I'm
just don't try. Like, why do you like you don't
like exercises in the like, mirror?
Listen,
just like
I can't be like you, dude. I cannot take 3 hours to make a 2-minute video because I get a bunch of losses. I can't do it, man.
Yeah, but mine, I kind of just like yell at the end. I mean, I don't even do it on purpose. I just yell when I get because I get really mad because people
see,
like target
okay,
you or something.
What,
it's like.
Would I rather be a sweat or would I rather be some rage monster?
Wow, dude. No, that's not what I'm saying. I'm saying it's like I would rather have a fail montage, like a fail like funny moments montage than like a video where I win because it's funnier.
I mean, fail montages are funny, but like I don't want all my videos to be that sort of thing. Like we did this
all of my videos
doing Team Skywars. You know, like that's I'm not triggered, Sammy. But like we did that one Skywars like Team Skywars video that did really really well for me actually on my channel where we literally just spent 20 to 30 minutes fucking trying so hard to win one Team Skywars game and we just couldn't do it
with who
so like I'm like you dude
oh frick yeah
that was a while ago but you don't remember that and I did well,
I don't
know
dynamic exactly
as
one.
Well wow root
oh dude, I'm
yeah,
terrible was- I lose a lot I can't like choose the losers
you
that I remember.
Yeah.
Pretty bad. Jake.
It was. I mean, it was fun and it did well, but I just don't want that to be all of my content because there are different people that like there are different reasons that you watch, like a gaming YouTuber. Either it's because they can do something that you can't, like all those big PvP YouTubers like Dante and
I
guess
I love
Uber Fudge, you can still, like count him, Grape, Private Fearless, Unforgettable, like people like that. Those are people that you watch not because of their commentary or because their content quality is actually good, but like to watch somebody do really well at something. Like it's like, it's almost like why somebody would watch the Olympics. Like you know, like that's really cool that they can do that. Or you watch something for its comedic value, and that's like a totally different thing. You know, somebody doesn't have to necessarily be good at the game, but you still want to watch it because you think they're funny or you think that they're sweet or whatever. Or you could be like one of those nude streamers that you watch because they've got big tits and you know you just
ooh, that's my favorite.
Are really horny and want to watch them twerk on camera.
That's why I watch Uber.
I watch Uber.
I should start doing that, dude. Hell yeah, bring the views.
Yeah, I'll just shave
just
my
throw
chest.
Throw on a speedo, bro.
Yeah, put on a bra. It's all good. It's all good.
Speaking of which,
next
yo,
podcast,
Sammy,
you'll see
the person triggering me right now is freaking Sammy. Freaking triggered.
I need help with something. Somebody added me to a list on Twitter and
yeah,
I don't
same.
Know.
Yeah,
how
they're annoying.
How don't worry about it. It happens every time you post a YouTube gaming link.
Yeah,
it's
pretty
quite annoying. You could probably just.
Do that with Havoc got host actually.
How,
you could
how
probably
do I leave
block
them
him.
Though?
Just go ahead and block at Incidific and you should be good to go.
Wait, did we all get added by the same person?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's got it automatic.
I got it added by Lewis Campbell.
Yeah, that is specific.
That is.
Anyway, moving past that.
Yeah, that was one topic for 20 minutes. I like.
Oh my god,
but,
dude.
I said that was two. So, you want to bring up the Call of Duty thing?
Well, not the Call of Duty thing, dude. The topic of the stream is next games of 2017.
Yeah, I was gonna skip down to the game predictions because I want to talk about that really quick. Like, first of all, we were just gonna talk about Call of Duty, but we're not gonna talk about Call of Duty. However,
next
Infinite Warfare though, Infinite Warfare and Battlefield 1. I know there's a coming out already. But I'm going to count this as 2017 anyway because fucking why not? Call of Duty sucks dick. Like,
yes, it's gotten a lot worse.
Infinite Warfare looks like absolute ass.
Fuck off. A lot of people are figuring that game
off. Seth, they're trying to copy Halo, but it's already a thing.
I 100% agree. I 100% agree that they're trying to copy Halo. Having, like, I now have Black Ops 3, I got it on sale and everything. And I enjoy it, don't get me wrong, but it doesn't feel like Call of Duty at all to me. Like, to me, Call of Duty is
not Call of Duty.
Me,
like,
Call
it just
of Duty is Modern ground. Warfare 2, yeah, Boots on the Ground, Modern Warfare 2.
Black Ops 1.
Even Black Ops 1, yes, Black Ops 1. That like, when we played that together, Jake, that felt like Call of Duty. I really enjoyed that. Like, when I went off quickscoping with that sniper on the very first map we played.
Yeah, the L96 A1 fella.
Not boxing gloves in Black Ops
3. Yeah, exactly.
Oh my god, I really wish that was recorded, dude. I got so mad.
and freaking, you know, wall running across the map. It's so dumb too. And every time I play a TDM, I get triggered as hell because on one particular map called Evac, the spawns are so fucked up that you can spawn with another person from the other team spawning behind you. It's so fucking dumb, and I literally hate it. No other Call of Duty has ever triggered me that much.
Yeah, you should have liked the video, by the way.
It must have triggered you.
Thanks,
like,
Sammy.
Hit
the fucking white button. I agree. Is this the bubblegum family? No. See, the bubblegum family is strictly pink.
Oh my god, not this.
My color's blue, Uber's is red.
No, yeah, if you want to be racist, yeah, just say this pink. Go for it, dude.
Jake, you don't have to be racist if you don't like certain frickin' races, okay? You don't need a date or certain race to not be racist.
Oh my god, Tyler Oakley shade, you know?
I was a roast on Tyler Oakley.
We don't need to talk about that, but I am gonna say that I fucking disagree.
Yeah, I disagree too. That's obvious. Who does it? That kid's retarded. He's more retarded than Uber.
Oh my god. I don't think that we need to attribute things to racism that are literally just like personal preference.
Yeah, you know, it's ridiculous.
Like, I don't know.
Freaking pink bubblegum. The only kind of bubblegum that's not
like,
racism, Jake.
Like if you know, if I'm allowed to date a girl cuz I like her long hair, but I don't want to date a girl that has short hair, then what's the difference? I don't know. Or like if a girl wants to date me cuz I'm tall but not another guy cuz he's short, and that's like the difference. Like, what? I don't understand.
Well, you're tallest.
Preference. It doesn't mean that you hate people with short hair.
Yeah, if you go out and say, like, if you keep on, like, if you burn people with short hair, then I think that's messed up. I don't know. I'm just pretty, like, you know.
Anyway, game predictions for 2017. So what do you guys?
Call of Duty Modern Warfare 4.
Well, 2017, we know there's gonna be another Call of Duty. So what's gonna happen? Like, what's the title gonna be? What's it about?
Call of Duty. It's gonna be Modern Warfare 4. It literally, like, 100% is.
No, wait, why would it be Modern Warfare 4? Because Sledgehammer, Sledge, Infinity Ward made. Wait! I have to pause the game here because I've put my thinking cap on. All right, so Infinity Ward made all of Modern Warfare's, and then Sledgehammer is just recently in, and they made Advanced Warfare, so wouldn't Infinity Ward make the Modern Warfare 4 if they were to make it?
What are you talking about,
Uber, shut up, you're not smart enough to listen to this.
Right? I blocked you, I was reading chat. And I was
Seth was about to answer me, you retard. Oh my god, you're taking me off. Uber, he just cuts off, like, and calls me stupid when I'm not even I made a good point.
I didn't hear you. That's what I was trying to say.
Yeah, of course, you freaking redneck scumbag.
Sounds like the kid's triggered.
Seth, what were you going to say? Or were you not going to say anything?
No, I mean, I think since they've already made Modern Warfare Remastered, they may hold off on Modern Warfare 4, but then again, I think that, I don't know.
Question, do you think it's going to be boots on ground or boots and fly?
I think they're gonna. It's gonna have to be boots on the ground. It has.
But
I want it to be, but it's.
They're not dumb enough. Okay, they're dumb enough to do Infinite Warfare after everybody like this. Everybody
no,
was
okay.
Like,
that's another thing, dude. They started making that game.
Don't make that mistake twice.
They started making that game. People liked Oh my god! Give me a second. When Advanced Warfare first came out, people liked it. Okay. When Advanced Warfare first came out, people liked it. So, right when Advanced Warfare came out, they began working on Infinite Warfare. And they're like, oh, well, this flying crap works. Why don't we try that with Infinite Warfare? And then by the time Black Ops 3 came out, people started not liking it. And then when Infinite Warfare was released, people hated it. Okay, does that make sense?
Such a bad game. Black Ops 1 is a
Uber,
bad game.
Uber, just Uber! You're not making any sense. Stop talking. You just say it's such a bad game. That's not what I was talking about. Obviously, it's a bad game, but they didn't know it was a bad game at the time. They thought people were going to like it, obviously.
The thing is,
they have a whole year
been,
to change it.
Let Seth talk.
It could not have been that difficult to change it. I really don't think, like, literally.
They were already 2 years into the production of it.
Yeah, ow. But like disabling the ability, like I think sliding is awesome. Like 100%
think. Yeah, sliding's good. But that was also
that they've added to Call of Duty.
Wasn't sliding in Black Ops 2?
No, it was dolphin diving.
Oh, well, yeah. where was sliding?
I like dolphin diving.
Oh, sliding was Advanced Warfare, I think. Right?
Yeah, it was.
Yeah, okay. So I think sliding is cool. I just wish they would take out the
whole jumpy thing.
Jumping.
The thing is,
wall running. I don't know how I feel about wall running. I think like if you could jump into a wall run, that'd be cool. Like if there was some place in the map where there was a wall run at eye level, you know, and you didn't have to like boost up into the air like 1,000 feet, so you're 20 feet above somebody, and you could just jump over into some insane line of sight, you know, and quick scope some dude on the other fucking side of the map. That's fucked up. Like that's just retarded. Yeah,
especially absolutely even on Nuketown, like the whole wall run thing. I think it's way overdone. I would agree with the, I like the wall running though. It's actually really fun. I wish they just like chilled it out and made it like in real life. You can wall run. Yes. It's not like freaking you can fly though.
Sammy says we should do a non-PG GTA stream. Honestly, if we just
GTA is non-PG. Full stop. You can't do a PG.
We don't even have. No one has GTA though.
Yeah,
you
no
be
has
but
Uber. Do you want to get GTA? Donate to me.
Did you guys understand what I was saying about them not knowing?
Yeah,
it was bad though.
No, I 100% know what you mean. Like they were, said they were 2 years into development. That's how long it's been since Advanced Warfare.
Because
which,
the second
I have not played.
The second they finished Ghosts, they began Infinite Warfare. Like there was no time.
So do you think the next game? What do you think, Jake? Do you think it's gonna be boosted on the ground? I personally do not think it's gonna be boosted on the ground.
I watched a video on this earlier. I watched a video on this earlier, and I forgot who it was by. I think. Frick! I think I can probably look at my history. Give me 1 second. You guys talk about something.
I hate to interrupt, but I have to head out. I have to leave.
All right. That's
all right. We will miss you.
Joy, man.
Have a great day.
Yes, bye.
Alright, well, while Jake's looking that up, I actually have one last thing that I want to talk about, and I think this is going to be the last topic for today, right? Okay, would you rather Coke or Pepsi?
Pepsi, I'm drinking it right
actually,
now. I'm drinking it right now. No, fuck
all right,
off.
What kind?
Pepsi.
Like, you guys thought it was totally normal. Serious thing, all right, but
normal?
Skipped it all.
Alright, so normal, Seth, I think personally... I think they both taste the same, almost.
I think really? Have a side. You're a liar.
No,
you're
have
a
liar. Side by
you
side.
A
you
liar.
Don't have a thing.
You
I drank
a liar.
They
no.
sound the dude. They sound the same.
No,
they sound the same.
Okay, guys.
They sound the same. They taste the same. One tastes a little different, like a little bubblier. But
there's two questions here. All right.
It has more carbonation, and then Pepsi to me feels like it has like a sweeter taste, but then again, like I like Coke more because I like a lot of carbonation and I'm not
wrong.
Sweet. No, wait, I'm not done,
wait,
bro.
Just regular
okay,
Coke
wait.
All Coke.
First of all, Coke like itself is better to me, but then I like Cherry Pepsi way better than I like Cherry Coke, and then I don't even know if they make Vanilla Pepsi, but if they did, it would be.
They
would live in the
Coke.
Shadow of Vanilla Coke. Yeah, that's like Vanilla Coke is one of my favorite things in the whole world. In fact, I think in my first ever setup tour, I literally
I think you got a Coke on your
like four bottles of Vanilla Coke.
Yeah, carbon,
like, okay,
yeah.
But
I
okay.
So
1 second. All right, there's two questions here. All right, there's Coke or Pepsi, and then there's the brand Coke versus the brand Pepsi. Like the brand Pepsi has Mountain Dew, and then like. The brand Coke has Sierra Mist or something, right? And then there's Orange Crush versus whatever.
See, that doesn't count because there's like three different Mountain Dews. So just like removing Coke and Pepsi, there's like a lot of choices within Mountain Dew.
Yeah.
You know, like there's regular Mountain Dew, which I'm not a big fan of, but I love like Code Red Mountain Dew. I love Voltage. I love Yeah, Baja Blast is pretty good. I love
it. Yeah, Baja Blast is awesome,
Pitch
dude.
Pitch Black is amazing.
Sponsored by Havoc.
Pitch Black isn't as great.
Does anybody remember what Mountain Dew was almost called?
No.
They held a contest to see what it was going to be called.
Oh, yeah, it was like Hitler or something.
Hitler
but
did
that wasn't
I remember that.
That wasn't Mountain Dew.
general,
yeah,
that
the
was
the whole entire thing. That was just like one type of drink.
It was one type of it, but it was almost called that.
I remember that. It was funny.
Oh, 4chan, you wonderful bastard.
That's funny.
Oh my
God. Okay, by the way, I found who the video is by. It's by Mr. Nobody Epic. He just did some Q&A video on MWR, and one of the questions was oh frick, I just lost my train of thought. One of the questions was, is the next Call of Duty going to be boots on the ground or not? And he said that making the next Call of Duty boots on the ground would be admitting that they did something wrong with Advanced Warfare, and they don't think that they did.
They need to admit that they did something wrong.
But
yeah.
they don't think they did something wrong. That's what he was saying in the video.
Jake, that franchise will die.
Yeah, no, do you see that?
Yeah, will.
No, Jake, they definitely have to know. You see, they're like the freaking most disliked video.
They know.
No, that's Advanced Warfare.
They did something wrong. Especially the way that Battlefield 1 is going.
Different companies, though.
Everybody is liking Battlefield 1 right now, even despite the fact that you have to use Origin to play Battlefield 1.
But
like EA
is different.
In many, many, many people's opinion, EA is like the scummiest of companies in the world. And yet people like Battlefield 1 far more than Infinite Warfare. Like people are like, now that the beta
the trailer
came out,
releases.
Yeah, now that the beta came out, people are like, it looks all right, but still nobody is even close to excited to play Call of Duty Infinite Warfare. Nobody. Not
only
like Nadeshot, Optic Nadeshot, the person whose entire career was built by Call of Duty. He's one of my favorite YouTubers in the world right now. He even admitted in like a sit down video, he was like, listen, like I'm gonna play it. He said that he thinks the guns are nice, he hates the movement still, and it ruins the game for him. Like there's one map on the beta where there's a like a wall underneath the map that runs from one spawn to the other spawn, and all you have to do is like boost down and then you can wall run to the enemy spawn. It's absolutely disgusting. And he says like he likes the guns more than he likes Black Ops 3 guns, but he's 100% gonna be spending more time on Battlefield 1 than on Infinite Warfare.
I think they're ruining COD, actually. If you look at it from a brand, like, before this, I would never, like, let's say MW2 and MW2 came out, I would never, ever think it would become where you can, like, fly around, you can be a robot, you can have
bots.
Never in a million years I would think that. I think, personally, Call of Duty, people loved it because of the guns, and because it was on the ground, it wasn't futuristic. If you want to play a futuristic game, you would freaking play Halo or some bullshit.
Yeah,
like that.
And like I love
Halo. Was popular. People were getting into space shit. They played Halo. Call of Duty was popular because they wanted to play like a Battlefield
kind
sort of
shooter.
Game. Yeah, really nice the kind of shooter.
Okay,
it was,
I think
easy to pick up. Like not like CS:GO where it's really hard. It was like anyone could play it and have fun and rage their ass off, and you could play for hours. With Call of Duty nowadays, I don't think it's not giving off the same vibe that it used to. It's not harder, but it's not. I don't really personally like it coming from the old Call of Duties. I think the whole like name of the company sort of changed.
Yeah, I agree, 100%.
I have what I think. Like, I want you guys' opinion on this. All right. So if they were to fix it,
boots on ground.
No, just in. Listen, all right. So there's two things that I think they could fix it. I think one is they fix the rotation. So the rotation is Treyarch makes World War II games, Infinity Ward makes modern games, and Sledgehammer makes futuristic games. Okay? Or they just switch all the way back to modern to World War II, and Halo does futuristic.
Yeah,
I think Halo needs to stick with futuristic because they know how to do it.
Yeah, I agree. I think that even the Halo games that people didn't really like as much as the regular Halo games, like Halo 5, everybody was like, it's an eh game. But like for somebody who's like an avid Halo fan, like I played Halo 1 all the way through, Halo 2 all the way through, Halo 3 all the way through.
Halo 3 was
the max
really
level, and yeah, I got to the max level in all the multiplayers on Xbox. Mm-hmm. Like even so, I really enjoyed that game. Like, it's one of the only reasons that there's still a console in my house was for Halo. So, like, 100%, I think that Halo is the only, like, futuristic game that's necessary. Obviously, there's other games. Like, there's, like, Mass Effect, right? Aren't they coming out with, like, Mass Effect 4 or something like that?
No, I don't play.
I don't know. I don't play that.
For that.
But, like, I don't know. I just feel like in terms of, like, first-person shooters, I think that, I don't know. Call of Duty, I feel like, was trying to pull away from Battlefield by, like, going into this, like, futuristic, like, crazy movement kind of thing. And yeah, because I think they dropped the ball.
I think they saw Halo doing really well. That was the big competitor against Call of Duty. It was Halo and Call of Duty on console and Xbox and shit. So it was Halo or Call of Duty. I think the people at Call of Duty were like, yo, Halo's making a killing. They're doing really well with Halo 3 and everything like that. Let's go and work on some futuristic more games. And hey, what's up, Buttload? How are you doing, feller?
Hey, sorry, I was late to the thing. Yeah, I just forgot.
We're actually just about to finish up. I think we were just about done with Call of Duty, right? We weren't even going to do that. We literally weren't even going to talk about Call of Duty. We were going to talk about game predictions, but then we got caught up in Infinite Warfare versus Battlefield 1.
I think that if Call of Duty, I think there would be a huge variety if they were to like change it. So, each developer made a different style of game. Right,
food.
What's up?
Yeah, food.
Your dad's calling. You can hear your dad calling you, bro.
who is my mom? Mom.
Your dad.
Mom, I'm busy. All right. What's up?
Okay. I was saying, like, if each developer made a different Call of Duty, so. I think Treyarch did World at War really well, so they can do World War II, like, type shooters, and then Infinity Ward did the Modern Warfare really well, so they can do infinite modern shooters, and then Sledgehammer, the only one they made is Advanced Warfare, so they're experienced with it, so they do that, and then each year, there is, like, a huge variety of games that people can play.
No.
If that makes sense.
Well, freaking... No.
I don't think...
That will ruin it. Because that would be, they sell six games $60, right? So that would be $180 with this spend a year. Then.
No, not a year. I mean, like...
Oh, I thought you said every year, three games.
No, year, same, right? Like, still
every
once
year. One
once
game
a year.
Comes out still.
That's
so,
already, like,
so, this year, there's futuristic. Next year, Treyarch... Mm-hmm. No. Next year, Treyarch would make a World War II game. Year after, Infinity War would make, like, Modern Warfare 4 or something.
Who makes
right?
the zombies, Jake?
Treyarch.
Alright, so I think Treyarch should make
a standalone zombies game. Is that
like
what you're in?
A standalone zombie.
Exactly. Yeah.
Like, sort of, imagine like a whole. Alright, so this is. I know this is probably not a good idea.
They've never. I don't even think they could do that.
But so, like, a whole zombies campaign. They did release one with Black Ops 3, but it wasn't like what we were looking for. I know, like, I don't know if Seth's really big into zombies. I really do like zombies. I think that's one of the things they did right in Black Ops 3. For sure, I definitely like the zombies in Black Ops 3, but
I don't.
The campaign wise,
it's too confusing.
Yeah, it's, for me, it's a lot of Easter egg wise, but
I think it's
a
just
whole zombies game year. Like, I know a lot of multiplayer won't be too big into that, but maybe like release two games that year, so like a whole zombies game and a regular game for people. Like, I think that'd be pretty fun because a whole zombie game, like maybe like a whole DayZ sort of setup. I don't really
I mean.
Know. Maybe not like that, but I'm just thinking, like, out of my brain. My brain's pretty...
I don't know. I would say, like, if they were to do a whole zombies game, it should be a whole separate thing, and they should still release a Call of Duty.
Yeah, so, Buttload, what is your opinion on Call of Duty? Duty.
Dude.
heck no. I really like the games, but I think I like the older zombies.
Like, yeah, I think that it was easier... It was a lot more fun to just get on and not have to think about it. Like, you just get on and kill stuff, and then you get off. Like, you don't really have to think about anything. You don't have to, like...
Get off?
What? That wasn't even funny, dude.
On that note, I think it is time to end it.
Let Paulo talk. Let him have more opinion.
Well, I mean, like, I agree completely with Drake saying, is like, it was a lot easier when you weren't running around looking for Easter eggs. And stuff like that. Not that you have to do that when you play, but like if you don't, like you're not gonna get anywhere.
No, I
agree
just
with you. Honestly, what was the very first one called? It was like
Nocturne Totem.
Like that was really good.
That was too boring.
That map. Oh my! Are you kidding me, dude?
It was way too boring. Like, there wasn't anything. Hours. It was just zombies and then a box, and you could buy guns off a wall.
No, for the first
way
game,
too
that was
boring.
The first map. I don't know if you played it when it came out. But for the first map, it was so fun.
Yeah, it was fun. Yeah, I'm not saying
it
wasn't fun. Yeah, I did, but it's not. It still wasn't like.
I mean, no, I'm not saying that it needs to be exactly like that. Like just one, like
I
four rooms
lacked.
And one mystery box. But I mean, have you played the Black Ops 3 Zombies?
It's stupid.
It's literally like a full size, like, I feel like, well, I'm playing Skyrim, like the map is so fucking big.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
Okay, turning into a goddamn monster to open a door, fucking, Jake. Like, it's just, I don't know. It's not zombies, it's like an entire separate game, which fucks with me.
When I used to play that, I actually wish that would sort of happen. I wish they made harder Easter eggs, because all the Easter eggs are really easy and stuff. So as when I was playing Black Ops 1, that's when I was that game was really easy for
Black Ops 1 Zombies is, I think, probably my favorite right now.
Yeah, me too.
I can get, yeah, but I don't like, playing that, I didn't really like it that much. Because I used to be able to get around 40 every single time without trying. It used to be really easy for me.
Big shot. I'm just saying, I think...
Tell us another fish door.
Okay. Honestly, I think Black Ops 2 was even pushing it a little bit with the stabs. And wait, was Black Ops 2 stabs or was that Black Ops 3?
Stabs? What does that mean?
No, the stabs and like the bows and stuff. Was that Black Ops 3 or Black Ops 2?
Black Ops 3? I don't think it was bows.
What was the last... Oh, Origins was... No, that was the last map of Black Ops 1. What was the last... See, I don't even know anymore because I don't
like
care.
The whole crafting system because like... The crafting system, I think, I find that annoying. Just to, like,
I like the crafting system. I think transit was how far they should take it, and then that was it. Like,
I hated transit.
Transit was good. Like it was still Call of Duty or not? Okay, it was still zombies, but it was just like it wasn't too far.
Same.
Because transit was basically four small maps with a bus that takes you to each one, and I really liked that.
I don't know. I thought it was overkill. Like, that was the first game, like, the first map they came out. I know it came out with all the other maps separate, but I think it was pretty overkill. When I used to play Black Ops 2 Zombies, the only map I played was just, like, the little town one with the little lava pack punch in there.
Yeah, that was a good map.
Don't get me wrong, I find it very fun. Like, I find it fun to watch. Like, I watched, Vanoss Gaming and whatnot do, like, them trying to figure it out and whatnot, but when they do it, it's, like, hilarious.
Alright guys, well, I gotta jump out of here. I wanted to end the stream a little bit earlier, but...
I think we're pretty much done, but...
I think we're about to wrap it up.
Right. Butler, you can keep talking, and then we can...
We're good. All I'm just saying is it's still enjoyable to watch. It's just, I don't think you personally would enjoy playing it.
Yeah. Right. I agree.
Story time, finish this shit off real
quick. Go for it, Uber.
Alright, so this week's story, retard story of the week, is how I broke my right arm. So, alright, so this is painting the picture right here. Third grade, bang, I was an idiot pretty much. I'm still a kid, I was even more of an idiot. So back then, there was like a little playground sort of set up, big. And yeah, there's like a big yellow slide, like a classic one, there's monkey bars and stuff like that, swings. So I liked, that was a little rebel dude. So my friend, hanging around with dumb friends that told me to do stupid stuff. So one of my friends told me to do a front flip off the yellow slide. So I did, and I got to the top. I stood on the yellow slide. There was like a little cover for rain on it. So I stood on the freaking yellow slide, the top of it, and I had a front flip off, and then I broke my arm by landing on it. So I didn't land on my feet. I landed right on my arm, and it snapped.
You freaking, god dang it, Uber.
You've been an idiot for a long time.
Yeah, so this isn't a new thing.
Pretty much. No, this is not a new thing. So yeah, my friends were like, oh shit, and they ran off, dude. I was like,
they were left?
Yeah, dude, they were scared. They were like, oh god, Uber's gonna get ticked. Well, they said didn't say Uber, of course. But, yeah,
that idiot.
That idiot. that retard that did the backflip off the slide.
So yeah, they freaking ran off, dude. Then the freaking bell rang, the people blew their whistles, so we go inside. So that freaking happened. This is elementary school, by the way. I don't think I brought it up, but yeah. So it's freaking, that happened. So then I didn't know what to do. I was like, shit, should I go to the nurse? Like, my arm was actually broken. Like, I could see, like, I was so dizzy. I was like, I wasn't crying. I wasn't a pussy. I definitely was crying. All right, I'm not strong. But yeah, I was crying, so I went into my class, and no one noticed, I guess, because I don't know what the fuck, everyone was retarded back then. So no one noticed I was like freaking, trying to I was definitely like holding my arm up in an awkward way, like my backpack was under it while I was sitting down. And then we were freaking like reading some book, and we're sitting on some like weird carpet thing, and there's like a whiteboard. and she like told me to write a sentence or something on the freaking board about what we were reading. So I go over to the board and I'm right-handed, and I try to write, and my freaking hand, like, she was like, "What the fuck is wrong with you?"
I haven't been listening. I don't know if anyone else has.
I was freaking trying to write with my right arm, and I couldn't because it was broken. So I was like holding it up in my left hand and trying to write, and it was going all squiggly, and I couldn't freaking write. And that's when she was like, "I think you need to go to the nurse." And I was like, "Yeah." And then I dipped out and go to the nurse, and then I found out I broke my arm.
Oh, man.
Damn, Uba.
Never, I wasn't listening, but I'm going to, because I was trying to focus on the game for a second, which is stupid, but I'm sure it was a dumb story.
Fucking Kamato, bro.
It was a very interesting
You would have
story.
Lost IQ points.
Yeah, I'm glad that I didn't listen. I just saved myself a couple points. IQ.
The evil gained IQ. Do you hear that,
person? Yeah.
All right, well, I think this is a good stream. We've been streaming for 40 minutes, approx?
Advertisement, 50 minutes.
50 minutes, Brox. Alright.
Jake, advertisement.
Advertisement.
Nope. Seth's not here. If Seth's not here, he can't use his code. Right,
do the advertisement.
Uber.
Guys, make sure to click the top link in the description and use code Bubblegum. If you click that link and you click the link and stuff, and you go to a website, which is pretty cool. And, yeah.
Have a dog.
There we go. Well, hopefully you guys enjoyed the podcast. Hopefully we'll do it next weekend if Jake isn't being Jewish again.
Oh my god, you just offended so many people.
You almost missed history, dude. I don't even want to get going. Yeah, but hopefully this channel might go switch to another channel. Me and Jake still got to talk about that a little more to make sure we finalize that, and Josiah needs to do some stuff. And by the way, hold on, we just want to bring this up real quick. Freaking Josiah said we'd be gone for a minute, and he does this every stream. He's gone for like...
He just ditches, dude. I mean... At least he showed up, I guess, but he doesn't even talk half the time.
Nah, but, he just yells in his mic for the first minute. And
yeah, the reason most people come to this is for Uber's retard story of the week.
I didn't even listen to it, dude.
That's because you're bad.
I come to the freaking podcast to argue with people about Call of Duty. No, I'm just joking, but I don't know.
Yeah.
The only reason I didn't want to come to this one is because I was freaking addicted to Skyrim, and I just got to play Skyrim while doing it, so I was good.
I think it was pretty fun watching you play.
Mm-hmm.
So
You guys are awesome. Stay awesome. Talk to you later. Peace out.
The frick?
Thanks.
You just went ham.
That's a little outro, dude.
That's an outro? Wait, am I supposed to end it? What the frick?
Did you end it?
I have to tab out of the game, so it's awkward. Alright.
Did you end it?
See you later, fellas.